Alright, let's put this one in full first. It has sound. So good. So well done. Love the backdrop here. All that fits. The only thing I would say is once you're around here every now and then, there's some moments where I'm not sure if it sits correctly on the ground. It's usually okay, but there are some moments just right through there where the feet are kind of sliding. I'm starting out with the pickiest of the pickiest things. It's just overall so good. There's really not that much to say. I still wanted to highlight this one because it's so cool. Again, the only thing would be having some moments where, even though we are kind of pretending that it's 2D, still kind of bringing in some of those folds in the toes, and maybe it's a bit more of an appealing shape, so it's not this flat-footed thing. So you can kind of rotate that around just a bit more, and then watching out on some of the silhouettes, even though this might be, I mean, it's, I'm not super familiar. I remember these from my childhood, but like poses like these and that, especially, like all of that seems very close to Tom, but I would still look at, again, just silhouette, so it's not so harsh there. Are moments where we're kind of losing what the arm shapes are doing, or giving this a bit too much of an angular feel. And even here, kind of changing some of those finger poses a bit more. And potentially, this is super picky about that, just folds right there. That finger's creating a tangent there. Not that I would clean it where I would have the hand here, the body here. You could, but again, this could be taken off of a very specific pose from the 2D version. If so, maybe through any type of tweakers, maybe lattices, getting rid of that shape. It really is more just little things like there. Even this, I would probably cheat that eyebrow in a bit more so that we see a little bit of the pupil and a bit of yellow. I think as we turn, see like this, you can cheat that pupil smaller so you can see part of the yellow, but that could be a bit more appealing. But it's already such a great expression. And what I love about this is that this feels very 2D, like in terms of the classic, the way it turns and the poses and all of that, like especially this, it's really nice, really, really nice Tom pose. And then you're getting into a bit more, oh, well, this is now, you know, nowadays, I like that. It's kind of the magic of taking a phone out behind his back. Really nice. I really like that. That look down, you got that. The nice shape with the ears and the tufts there. All that is really, really nice. Arms coming out. I know, again, like how far do you go with 2D and 3D, where if you move this wrist up, I would still probably do a little bit of movement, a bit more this way in the forearm. And just spacing-wise, if you look at that elbow, how that elbow comes out, and then once we hit here, it's kind of hitting that wall. Little spacing things here and there, or intersections on the thumb here and there, and again the feet, so they're not so flat. There's a little slight rotation there, which is good. I would still push some of those toes in. Even here, I could have a little bit of a toe in and out. There's still some movement there, which is good. That's a tricky silhouette. It still kind of works with the light. I do really like this. That is just, it's so good with that. The softness there, the anticipation going into that, like that to me is so Tom. In a, I mean, very vague recollection of my childhood. I would still be careful here as that arm goes up. It feels like this, almost pivoting off of that area through there. And maybe having on that hand a bit more to the left, and then for the compression down here, and then on that pushing the fingers out for compression. And watch out, this, if you look at the spacing, this, and then bam, locks through there. Like little things here and there. It's just overall so good. I just wanted to play that and highlight this clip. All right, thanks. Another clip here that's awesome, also with sound. So good. Again, just like with the other one that I had, there's not super much to talk about just because it's so good. It's just minimal things for polish. I just love the style of it. I think the poses are really cute. I think the idea is really cool to do all of this. I love that there's interaction. You got the wheels there, that the prop is moving. You got little movements there in the box. all of that is there. So the like picky things would be like you put something into a box and the box is moving, but nothing else is moving on top there. I would have a little bit of a watch out for that. I like that. It still shows the character in there. In terms of Tom, there's some moments like these when you have your leg pose like this and you move over with the foot. There's nothing going on here. You even have really a lot of movement in that leg. And then it starts to move a little bit. I like that the toes are animated, there's a little drag there, but just overall that just feels a bit too broken up where it's just too much of an IK leg. And then even as you move over and you got some pressure there, even though it's cartoony, it would still have a little bit of squash there to show that you are putting pressure on it. You can see that with this, and then you have here maybe more pressure on the heel, maybe even the toes might go up a tiny bit and then you come back down. Just little things like that. Also, when you have moments with this coming out, if you play this in real time, it's just a bit harsh, just the way the head moves over there and then pops up but then goes straight the other way. And if that, then I would go a bit stronger with the overlap on the hips, and I would also watch out to not cover too much. It's barely covered, but still you could easily move this out a bit more and then come back so we don't cover too much of the face. Speaking of the face, I like all the cute eye pose and the changes there. But even then, spacing wise, there's some moments where the head just moves over very horizontally, very very straight there, and then pops back down. So it's watching a little bit on those arcs, just a tad. Even on this, you got a pivot right where that nose is. So something like this. Even this, the cat going over, it feels very straight, very IK, horizontal, no arcs. I would play with that just a bit more. Got a good drag on that tail with that sudden move on the cat, but you could play a little bit more on that face is very straight on. So at this, have a little bit of a drag and horizontal in those ears, dragging just a bit, and then they can come back out here for a little bit of overlap. Just tiny things like that. But overall, again, just picky, picky, picky. I got like a lot of hand poses like that with the fingers. That's great. But then you could have something where if that's kind of the ta-da, the relaxed pose as it goes over to throw, maybe a little bit of a curling in to grab it a bit more just for that moment, and then to reopen the fingers there, stuff like that. Again, toe stuff, I'm always kind of picky on toe things. As you compress here, it'd be nice to get these a bit closer and then compress out. I do like that, that little quick move in with the tail dragging, and that's great. Cute little boop, boop, little hop to go in there. Again, there's a lot of really cool stuff. I'm just pointing out super picky things, like going down, even this, you can have a little bit of a slight change on that head rotation and that spine, so it's not going into a curve in the body like this and then going into a straight too soon. But I do like that change here, a little drop in the hips. You could also have a little bit of a wire rotation just again on that finishing that turn, maybe overshoots a bit and then comes back. Tiny tiny things I do like this here. Cha-ching. And it could be moments where maybe bring that shoulder lower to get into a nicer curve overall, so you don't have that break there. But there's some, again, some good stuff there. Watch out, this feels like a big intersection on that, but that could also be the prop here. Let me see that handle. I don't know, there's some slightly funky, maybe not, I'm not seeing the wrist rotation. I'm not sure. This felt like a really big intersection. And then the hand, I would personally at this point, even if it's one frame, you can really pose that one frame where it's not like this. You got your wrist a bit more aligned with the forearm, and just adjusting the finger poses, which then can lead right into that rotation out there. I love that jump there. Let's play this again. And that's cool too. All that. That could have a little bit of nose over rotation a while bit, and then come back to slight changes in rotation. Even here, that could have a slight move over there with a slight tilt to go into that. It's really funny though. Great change. Oh, great shape there. That instead of horizontal, I would give it again a little slight as you go down, slight rotation to then come back into that, which can lead right into this. Love that one. Bam! Really explosive. But then jump there. Oh, I'm getting ahead of myself. But then a little bit of more structure on the arms. And then watch out those wrists. I know this is really fast, but since we're in there frame by frame, be kind of nice. Even stuff like that, do not have a tangent that gets kind of close out. Even move that foot out to get a bit more of a cleaner silhouette. So little things here and there. It's great though. I love that too here. Same thing here. You can have on that lean over with that weight going back, a slight change in toes there. Just to get a little bit more life. I know this is on twos and it's all cartoony exaggerated. Just little things could be kind of neat. Like even if you go something like this and you move over, and we're bringing a slight foot roll with a slight banking with more pressure on these toes. So that toe goes up and maybe that toe is a slight curve down for pressure and then you come back. So it's not so completely cut off IQ wise. That's kind of that picky, just because it's really cool. Here's another one that's awesome in its presentation. It also has music. Let's play this first. That's so good. Oh, I love this. I should probably move my face out of there so you can see the little guy. Lots of cool stuff. I love how even when he goes up here, I talked about this, about limited animation, be careful in CG, where this is really so straight and clean, but it gets saved by this hold up with the head. It's super subtle. And then that exhale, I think that's great. Even a little bit of finger animation in there. There's some really good stuff there. It could have an ever so slight rotation in Y just a bit, but it is pretty funny how it just comes up really cleanly in there. Maybe on that little settle there, I don't quite see, but maybe something in the whiskers, little tiny thing. But it's already great. The main thing why I'm picking this one to look at is that I would love for all of this, because all that stuff is really well done. I really like the transitions. You got the big lines there, really fun poses, the rhythm of this. I love all that in the head here. All the looseness in the forehead. I love how the squash and stretchiness on the little bounce on the carrot. I think it's great too. How he just drops down, you can see some of these like that. It's great. Little shapes there. Fun poses in there. Balancing on this and all that. Again, I love that little sideways move for this and that popping into that. All that is great. The only thing I would do, again, not that this is wrong and bad, but I would love for this to see a slight change where it's not just that, where it's kind of a on repeat. There could be something where over this, there could be maybe a slight change in the eyes going, maybe a bigger smile, it's being a bit more and more happy about this, and even potentially lowering that arm over time. I mean, or you can argue the opposite where, you know, this gets heavy, or it is heavy, and as you cut this, it gets lighter. I know this is not like just cartoon stuff, you know, think about physics and everything, but I'm looking at just slight changes so it doesn't settle into a cycle. Because it's so nicely done in 3D. It's such a nice look. That'll give this a bit more complexity, something a bit more. Even this head detachment seems a bit where it could land in a different way and have a slight bigger influence on where the body ends up. A little bit more. And again, I'm mentioning a change in the arm is over time drop or up. And this is for you to reason why it would go up or down. But I think that would be a bit nice. Same thing with this. So it's not so cycly, but it could be where maybe at the very beginning be a bit more off balance, maybe a bit wigglier, and then settle into what he's doing at the end. Nice stretch there. And same thing at the end. Even though they're all fun and it works, the rhythm is great, and I love it with the music too. It could be something where it's just a slight progression where you start, that's the beginning, but then towards the end, it's just in a slightly more pushed pose and headspace and whatever Tom is thinking at this point. I love this though. I love that the change goes into that turn. Now we lose the shakers around that and this shows up. This is all great. And even that has a slight keep alive repeat there where I'll just tweak this a little bit. Could even go be up and then on that breathing, on that down, one more little squeeze on the eyebrows, a little widening of the mouth, just a tad. Very, very picky. Now, a bit more picky on this one is that there's such big changes in Tom. And if I love how he's there, but the breathing, a little movement in there, all that. It's nicely, feels really like it's settled and laying on that pan. I think that's all really great. And he goes, no. But, and I love that, like little pieces, the animation of little pieces, it hits the head, little bounciness there. You can see how little guy reacts, hits his eye there. Oh, that's great. But the only thing I wish was that on those big X hits, that it would almost make him go a little wince, a little eye move, a little change, something that shoots through his body. Because I love this, because it looks like what's going on. And on this, like this would be, I'm zipping straight in your face to have a slight little take there and a slight little reaction. And then maybe down, it feels oddly relaxed how he goes back down. Because that stuff like that, you might argue, well, then it's all the time. So maybe slight variation how he reacts or it reacts to the takes. But that's the only thing here. Even on this feels like, on that, I would probably get more tension in those fingers and relax them a little bit more. Not that they are relaxed at the end, but a slight change. Not just in the rotation of the wrist, but slight changes in the fingers. Well, that's the only thing, because I do like that reaction there. Maybe it's a bit water balloony soft. I would probably take a couple frames out, give it a bit of a snap. But like overall, it'd be kind of fun to have some more reactions. Could be a big thing at the beginning. You know, there's something that landed on his head, so maybe through there he goes like a little head shake, and then, oh, where is it? And then leans up to look at this, and then that would be, go back, and what is this? And maybe you know, closing the mouth and or a blinking, but you imagine salt and pepper, all that stuff on his face, that could have a slight reaction on him, and then that little slightly snappier thing at the end. Ow, picky. Again, I'm looking at this, it's really well done. I love it. It's really fun, really nice presentation with the renders. These are just picky notes for anybody that watches this. Hopefully that is helpful and interesting, and that's it. All right, here's another one, also with sound. So many memories when you just hear that sound. Let's bring it back. It's so good. Also, this seems very, very close. Again, this is speaking out of my nostalgia, childhood memory of especially this, like the jumps back. This seems so straight out of the old cartoons. That I love this here, especially given with that move over for that nice line of action, that weight shift, and then that just that face, like these are two such classic faces, and then into the scramble for the run out. Again, really cool. Wanted to just highlight that clip just because it's really well done. It feels very, very old school Tom. The only thing would be what I mentioned other shots before, just the pickiness that I have for some of the shapes and potentially looking at cleaner silhouettes, but also just not having this brick as a foot. And in this case, also with the run, I would probably go something where, again, even though we're emulating 2D, just kind of we are still, you can tell, in a 3D world. So having that Tom end up maybe head here, and then throughout all of this, get to that point so it's not so locked in 2D space. Was because of that, you start to feel that head detachment where there's something really IK headish, head align, whatever your that control you want to call it, what are we familiar with, but it just seems very detached. You can see how those arms go up and down. I would have a little bit more side to side roll and maybe some up and down, just like a roll down with the nose struck up and down here. Just something to break that up a bit. It just seems a bit, you know, this might be, again, my memory is hazy, but this might be taken straight out of the 2D version. But even then, I would just tweak a little bit, even that tail, to not go into like a full cycle, have a slight little change, and again work a little bit more on clean silhouettes and bringing those toes down. That's good. But on then, you imagine that would come back into more of a curl, just stuff like that. To me, that's really cute though. I still love all those big arm poses into that. That is just so much fun. I love all this. And then it goes back to what I mentioned on the clips, the compression on toes, stuff like that. I think your hang time is great. You could have slight straight path here. I would give this a bit more, whoa, a bit of an arc in there, just a tad. And just because we'll be in there in 3D, the slight changes. Again, this is probably taken out of the 2D version, but slight changes in this on holding and tightening of the fingers, just little changes so it doesn't feel like this is the pose, and then you just have stretchy arms holding on to that. I do love this though, and that's great. Stuff like that is really great. Even here, can have a little bit of a change in the fingers before we let go. This, especially with all that weight shift, has a lot of changes there that I would put in the foot subjectively, and then it goes back into this again with the head and the toe and the foot shapes, and probably on that sudden speed up when you go and slide, so that's like go on this, actually straightening the tail for like a really speed, maybe stretch that tail to some degree. It's so good though. Again, it's a fine line between emulating 2D and putting in too much 3D-ness in there in terms of detail that takes away from that feel, but it is, especially in this case, rendered still with a 3D feel to it. But it's really good. I also want to highlight this when he jumps, the end of the head, that bounciness is really good. Doing, doing, and then goes into boring with the ears and just the bounciness, how that settle is. Like, that's really nice. I really, really love this whole end here. Pull out into that. Also, the head shapes into that with his eyes. That's super appealing. Love all that stuff. And then going back into, I got to get back to chasing. Yeah, so lots of cool stuff, as always. Little picky notes here and there, but really, really cool. Here's another one with sound here. The only thing with this one is that it's too bad that the sound doesn't continue. So it's kind of odd when it just kind of comes in and then kind of stops. That's an odd. Okay, I remember that Tom did that. Again, not that I know all of the episodes. This is all childhood memory stuff. But the reason I'm picking this one is, I'll be careful generally. This is actually, I did another clip by the same animator, but just in presentation. If anybody watches this and sends any type of work for contests or anything, or especially in your reel, you want to make sure that all that stuff is gone. No camera mask, gate mask, or anything. So it's very clean in terms of presentation. I wanted to include that one, but also I really like this section through there. Again, this feels very old school Tom, and I love that change in those arms. It's such a great pose to cross these to then get out into that, and that feels also very Tom. But also the main reason why I'm grabbing this one is because of, even though this is all exaggerated and cartoony and you got all the nice poses and very reminiscent of the 2D Tom, let's pretend, again, I can't remember if this is straight from the 2D cartoon, but if you have something like this, I'd still be careful in terms of, if you go out this way and then you hold that and you go back and it's in CG, just, I know there's something that just, to me, accentuates that very clean CG line where it's just too straight. Even detachments on the head, when you see that growing here, the head kind of drags. To me, it would be, if you do this, you start to go down with the head, but maybe a slight, again, rotation in Y to then go back up here. And then when you're done with this, even on this, you can see the offset in that arm. So that might already pull that head and twist it over this way with a slight rotation and then come back down. Just a slight more complexity in that curve. Then once you're here, again, that feels so old school, which is great. So this is a short and sweet version, but to me, that's just a slight weird tweak there, or weird moment where it's just too computery, and I would make a slight tweak, give this, even this as you go down, could have a slight dip in that root, so it's not so locked through there. And then usually what I talk about feet, so kind of looking at posing, this is ever so slightly overlappy there. We see a little bit of negative space. This could be tweaked a tiny bit where maybe that foot would have a bit more clearance and maybe not so straight down, maybe with a little bit of a move out for a slight triangle there, just ever so slightly. Even this here on that hand, sometimes there's some spacing moments where it feels like it's a bit too pivoting off of right there as the rest of the wrist rotates over. Or give this a bit more of a moving hold on the upper arm to get into this and potentially just kind of reshaping some of these lines so they're not so even here, giving it a certain route. And it's like, this feels really nice with the squash and the stretch in this case here. So giving that same feel in there will be kind of nice. Even here, to kind of dip a little bit in there. I just love this. I could play this forever. Just that turnout, so good. So a short clip. So I want to mention that anybody watching this, watch out for any type of one axis moves and too clean of a CG move. And even though you want to emulate 2D and be more cartoony, having slight complexity in rotations in the head and changes in the root, it's going to help you loosen it up a little bit. And that's it. Next up is this one that has no sound. You would think that there is sound, but you can maybe make up your own music there in the background. So good though. Again, one of really, really good selection here in this competition where I don't have super much to say, where it's mostly tiny things, especially like a moment through there on the head and on the exit where something feels slightly off in terms of the perspective of where it's going. But it's overall, it's such a great idea. So the biggest thing would be, I mean, there's a limit usually in the frame. So it might be something where he comes out just a bit more, where I would delay this until Tom's out maybe this far. So we have a nice look. You get the attitude, eyes closed, happy. And then shoo, then this guy comes in that can do all of this and then lead to that moment. Instead of both kind of trying to get our attention at the same time. And if I look at just that, I know that rig, it's really nice, a really nice line. It really helps that it's so dark in terms of the silhouette. Something like this, I'd be careful when you have such an exaggerated hip turn here where it's really, really pivoting off the middle, or give this an ever so slight move. Also giving this a bit of a, not that far, but you know, some lean on there to push this, but so it doesn't feel so. I rotated a controller and there's the pivot right there. I think that'd be the biggest thing, but there's some really nice exaggerated moves and nice drag finger poses here each frame. It's really nice. It's really nicely done over the whole thing. If I'd be picky, maybe that would be like one different close up frame. It's not the same, almost like a repeat of the pose, but it's really cool. Again, watch out in real time. Has a nice weight to that. I love how it gets down and then relaxes into that softness into this. It's really good. Love seeing all that. And if you look at Tom, I love this here. I love that the out and then the arms come up and then how they kind of swing like this into that cute walk. And it feels like it's always a bit different. Each step has something in there. Really, really cool. Definitely more limited. So once you get into that, there's some very, you know, big moves in the body that only affect certain areas, where here you could have a slight change in the hips and in the root ever so slightly, but it already works really well. As to me, for something like this, whenever it's CG, even it looks nicely stylized there with the renders, there's a slight thing of when this moves back, maybe again you look this in 2D, it would be so forgiven, but I think of CG, and every time a head just moves straight back, anything that moves so straight, or the body moving a little bit and the wrist completely locked, I always feel like that just feels so CG. And even if you want to emulate 2D, I'll bring in a little bit of, even if it's a tiny pixel change, just a slight movement in there. You can see this here, how there's just a bit more life in there. So all that stuff is nicely done. I love all this. This is great. You can see all the changes here in the ears and the hair to clean poses. Love all that. But the rhythm is great. How he goes down. Bing. Doing nice hold on that leg. What? And that, you can see the toes there, toes wiggle. It's so well done. I really, really like that clip here. The whole thing would be this here, again, where the face feels almost like it's a 2D card, where you got, at least there's some movement there. That's good. I like that, that there's at least some movement in there as there's bigger movement there. But then as the head moves around, it just feels like it's an overall translate with no rotation. I would still have a slight rotation in there, so it's not this 2D card that feels attached to it, more of a 3D element. Love that. Look at that. Come on, you gotta go frame by frame. So great going into that again. So many elements. I don't have really too much to say, just because there's nicely posed up fingers and changes, got a camera shake in there. And again, this game could be for me where all that stuff is moving in and just feels very, very locked. So anything where you, even if you try to eliminate 2D, just watch out any type of IK moves and heads and wrists and feet. And the only thing here is that it will feel like it will exit this way and not crab sideways out there. And again, there's a frame limit, but having a full exit on Tom and the face and the hands, that'd be the only thing on here. I love this though. I love the idea that, boom, goes into this, like, and it keeps going. The musical gets forced into that dancing. The look around going, wait a minute, what is going on? Into that, and then trying to scramble. It's great. It feels like you want to scramble with like maybe like eyes closed, like and then trying to scratch the floor and try to stay in the place. Anyway, that's that. Lots of picky notes here and there. It's just so well done. I love this. So good. And that's it for me. Boo boo.